So I didn't even make a special appointment. I went in for my primary care visit. And at the end, as an afterthought, I looked back at my doctor and I said, you know, I've had this very, very mild shake in my leg. And I was just wondering if I should do something about it. And she said, ah, it's just a pinched nerve. And she said, but you know what? Just because we want to be safe, let me send you to a neurologist. I had an appointment about a month later. She sat me down for the consultation. She asked me some questions. And then she asked me if anybody in my family had ever had Parkinson's disease. And I told her that my uncle did, but he had passed. And she said, you have Parkinson's disease.
When somebody has Parkinson's disease, they lack a neurotransmitter called dopamine. And what happens when the brain doesn't have dopamine, the brain is sort of analogously having an arrhythmia. And that arrhythmia is causing a lot of motor symptoms, the typical symptoms that you see in Parkinson's disease: tremor, slowness of movement, rigidity, freezing of gait.
I was sitting by my computer and I'd feel my left leg. It would tremor a little bit, but very, very lightly, like you couldn't see it and you couldn't feel it, but I just felt like almost you plugged it in to a socket and it was like zzzz. Even though everybody has different symptoms, once they start the medicines, we all come up with the same kind of final summary of what happens with the disease, and that's the medicines don't work well.
Medication is still the gold standard for treatment of Parkinson's disease. However, as the disease progresses, a lot of patients become unresponsive to medication, or they need to take an amount of medication that is really difficult to tolerate.
There's a multitude of medications. All of them essentially do the same thing. They either try to augment or increase the level of dopamine, or they actually replace dopamine directly.
So your life is ruled by the medicines. So I go on the medicine and I'm taking 4 pills a day, let's say. You know, and then the 4 pills aren't lasting. So for instance, I'd know I'd have like maybe 2 hours on the pill, sometimes an hour and a half, sometimes 2.5 hours. I go into the grocery store and I'd fill up my cart with groceries and I'd be fine, perfect. And then all of a sudden my medicine would turn off, like my symptoms would come back with a vengeance. So at that moment, I would like leave my groceries and run out the door because I didn't want to run into neighbors and have to explain. And a lot of times I had trouble walking.
The problem with these medications, and it doesn't really matter in all honesty which one you use, is that over the course of time, as you use the medication, although it's extremely effective initially, when you use it chronically, all patients, without exception really, start to develop complications of the therapy itself.
And then it started causing me side effects. I started getting, I didn't know what it was at the time, but my left leg, the same leg that started jerking, and I'd be out to dinner with my husband and another couple and they'd all be talking and laughing. I'd be sitting there under the table with my foot making all these funny movements, and all I could think about was how my foot was under the table and I couldn't laugh and join the conversation because I always had to worry, was my medicine gonna work? Was it not gonna work? How was I gonna feel? Was it gonna have side effects?
That's where deep brain stimulation comes into play. This device delivers electrical current to these deep areas in the brain. And essentially by doing so, it makes the brain think it's in its normal physiologic state, not having an arrhythmia anymore, and essentially improves a great deal of their motor symptoms that they deal with on a daily basis.
When you get to a point, and I think that a lot of people that do contemplate DBS, you get to a point where, you know what, I'm going nowhere but down, and I'm not doing well as it is. So when I got to the point where I felt like the disease was ruling my life, and the medicines that I were on was ruining my life, you know, that I knew I had no other choice. So it was the only chance I had to get better.
The advantage of deep brain stimulation is that it's a procedure that can really titrate the intensity of the stimulation based on the patient needs. The fact that it's reversible and titratable makes it a very good technology.
After you have the surgery, you have to let your brain swelling go down so they don't turn it on right away, so your symptoms are still there and they come back in a vengeance. And then I'm waiting to get programmed. And the programming is when they actually go into a computer, find your device from a computer, and program it for your symptoms. And so I go into the doctor's office and I'm waiting for him to turn it on to see also if it worked, because I've gone through all this and I want to make sure that it's going to be effective. And I'm sitting there at the chair and my legs are going nuts. And I'm getting the really bad dyskinesia on my left leg, and I'm just feeling terrible, like a brain fog. And he goes into a computer, which was amazing, and he finds my device on the computer, and he starts doing things on the computer, And next thing I know, my shaking totally stops. My brain fog goes away. I look over. My daughter, who's 19, is hysterically crying. And that makes me cry because my kids really are. And then he programs it again and changes it up a little bit, and I get better again. Walk out, went out to lunch with my family and had a nice day, and ever since. And you do have to go back to the doctor to make sure, because as the symptoms progress, as the disease is still progressing, it's not a cure, the doctor still has to go back and program you as your disease progresses.
Not everybody that has Parkinson's disease is a good candidate for this therapy.
The biggest challenge in getting deep brain stimulation for patients is really assuring the patient that this method is safe and the risks are minimal.
You want to feel like you felt before you had Parkinson's disease. This device is not going to make you feel like you felt before you had Parkinson's. You will always have Parkinson's. You will never feel like you felt before Parkinson's, but it will substantially improve your quality of life and help you with a tremendous amount of those motor symptoms of the disease.
I still maintain my house. I still run a business. I help my husband with his business. I'm still a mom, even though now they're in college. But you know, I wasn't gonna let it totally take me down. We just got back from Europe. We went to Budapest, Prague, and Austria. And I actually walked the cobblestone streets of Prague with no problem late at night, which was wonderful. So I'm trying to do it while I can again.
If you're ever interviewing somebody that tells you that every patient they've operated on has been happy, they're probably, you know, twisting the truth a little bit, right? It's like anything else in life. I've done this procedure now over 1,000 times over the last 14 years. And I can honestly tell you, not everybody's happy. But at the same time, there's no guarantees when you do something like this. And I can tell you over the years, I've never had a single patient come to me and say, number one, I want the device removed. I've never had a single patient who turns off the device. I think every patient, when selected appropriately, gets a benefit.
The best thing is I'm off all the Parkinson's meds, which are terrible. So I can eat anytime I want. I don't have to worry that I'm walking the streets of Prague or New York City and worry that my walking will turn off. Of course, if I do get really, really nervous or anxious, you know, I can show some symptoms, but nothing like I did before. And I don't know if you want me to show you, but basically you can't even see. This is my battery right here. Get up every day and live your life, because none of us know and none of us are immune to walking into a doctor's office any day and getting a devastating diagnosis. So live your life, and if the symptoms get to the point that they got with me or that they've gotten with many people, there is hope and there is a place to go.